Hey everyone, welcome back to the Standard Super League. Luis Scott Vargas here with our victor, Kenji Igashira. That was quite a match.
That was intense, especially that last game. You know, maybe the first hand I could have kept. I don't know about you. Oh my god, I had the echo on. One sec, let me cut this off. Oh, there we go. I don't know about that first hand. Do you keep five lands, Impulse, and the Soulfire Grandmaster? Like, the Impulse can deal with an early Jace or something, but
I probably would keep that, but I don't think it's bad to mulligan it either. I think that the second hand is actually kind of interesting too, but like I said, it's actually fine mulliganing, just given that how quickly Mantis Rider can decide games.
Yeah. I mean, again, the double dig through time kind of put me off. I thought, you know, I was not casting anytime soon, so
yeah.
I guess I just drew better than Tom, who seemed to flood out that last game. But that first game, too, man, I bricked for so many turns. It was like back and forth.
That first game was pretty intense. It took him a couple good top decks to get back into it, and then you just peeled the Mantis Rider on the last turn. So it was a pretty good one.
It was nothing could match the Reed Owen game, though. Especially that game one. That was one of the better games I've seen on the Super Leagues.
Yeah, we've had some awesome games tonight, and hopefully that we continue that trend. We've got a really cool match coming up. We've got Dave Williams on the Bant Tokens deck and Li Shi Tian on Four Color Rally. So it actually puts me in a kind of funny position where I want to play against Dave's deck, so I hope Dave wins, because I'm playing the winner of this if I win my match, which is, of course, not a given. But if Dave wins, that means he's good against Rally, which is what I'm playing. So I'm not 100% sure what I'm hoping for, besides just a good match of Magic, I suppose, not to face any Anafenzas.
you're playing a very similar deck to Li Shi Tian's, aren't you? The four-color Rally as well?
It's similar. One notable difference is that I don't have Anafenza in my sideboard. We had it for the Pro Tour. Matt Nass did play this deck, and I ended up cutting it because I didn't think anyone was going to play Rally. Lee did not cut it, so he's got Anafenza ready to roll here.
Yeah, I like Lee has, if we can bring up the Lee's deck list, he's got a Bring to Light as a one of, and it's kind of just, you know, not just Demonic Tutor, it puts it into play, so.
It's not bad. It doesn't get Rally, unfortunately, because there's no X there, but it does get, you know, Nantuka Husk, Collected Company is a decent target. I can't really get behind not having the fourth Nantuka Husk, though. That actually seems insane to me, but you know, Lee presumably has tested this deck. We never tried cards like Kalastra Healer, for example, so maybe that makes the deck play differently enough.
And yeah, I was going to ask you about that, actually. The Kalastra Healer, I've been playing a lot of Dark Jeskai online, and I haven't seen any lists with the healer yet. Did you test that at all for the Pro Tour?
We did not test Kalastra Healer. We're aware of it. I mean, we looked at it, but I think the deck doesn't have a problem killing. It's really a problem, you know, getting disrupted by your opponent. And, you know, the way this deck works is you really just try to dump a bunch of creatures in play, and a Collected Company helps with that. And then just cast a big Rally of the Ancestors in between, in this list, Kalastra Healer and Zulaport Cutthroat. You can usually drain them out by sacrificing everything to Nantuka Husk.
Yeah. Now, if we take a look at Dave's deck now, he was talking about earlier, he's playing the green-white, not Megamorph exactly, but is it Tokens, I guess?
Yeah, people have been calling it Bant Tokens, even though it's really just like a mono-white deck with Visionary and Nissa and then Dispel. But it's playing a bunch of cards that make tokens, and most notably, Retreat to Emeria. Retreat to Emeria is really the card that makes this deck pop, because between Fetchlands and Blighted Woodland, you can just make a million tokens or give, you know, go something like End of Turn, Secure the Waste, and then untap and play Retreat to Emeria, play a Fetchland, sack the Fetchland, and just attack for a million.
So, yeah, I was watching some guy named Paul Cheon, I think it was, earlier today, and he was playing a really similar deck. And yeah, he had one turn where he End of Turn, Secured the Wastes, already had a Gideon in play, Emblem the Gideon, played another Gideon or whatever, and, you know, all of his guys all of a sudden have +2/+2 and just swing in for 100 million.
Yeah, I mean, that's why he's number 17 in the Cheon power rankings. So, you know, plays like that. But, you know, I would assume that you're moving up given your victory over Tom Martell here.
That is the hope anyways. We'll see if I can beat Owen in the next match. I think I've got a lot of practice versus Jeskai, so hopefully that's a thing to see. Who do you think is favored this matchup, David or Li Shi Tian?
Oh, I'm gonna have to go with Li Shitian by a pretty wide margin, actually. This is one of the more lopsided matchups you would find in standard. I mean, it's not just game over because Dave does have two copies of Dispel and that counters both Rally and Company, and he's got a reasonably fast kill with Retreat to Emeria. But I saw Matt Nass play against Ben Stark in the Pro Tour, and even though Ben did mold a 5, he will tell you that I think that the matchup is fairly favorable for Rally just because the green-white deck doesn't kill quite as fast and only has the two dispels that really interact with Rally meaningfully. So it's a matchup I would expect to be in Rally's favor. And post-board, Dave has one dispel to bring in. That's basically the extent of it. So that's not a... I mean, maybe he can bring in some surges or something, but that's still not really going to change things. Den Protector is nice with dispel. I will give him that. That having Den Protector to bring back dispels is kind of nice. But in general, I'd rather be on the Rally side of this, and that's why I hope I am in round two. But I've got to get by Gerard first, which, you know, is going to be difficult.
Sure. Notably, Surge doesn't exile the creature or anything. It destroys it, so the Rally deck can just sacrifice it in response or anything like that. But it should be interesting. Oh, man. What is the first thing you were going to do if you 2-0 this last chance qualifier pod?
Probably go to bed because it's just going to be like very late. thanks to Reed Duke and his charge lands, you know, taking the full 80 minutes. Not that I didn't enjoy watching that match. That was a very enjoyable match to watch. But given the time it took, you know, I think we're gonna be out of here pretty late if I do end up doing well, or if you end up doing well.
Hopefully. It's what, 9 p.m. your time, I guess? Something like
that. It is, yeah.
All right, that's not too bad. Are you going to be at Quebec City this end of the week, I guess?
I'm not. I'm not going to that or GP Indy. And I will be going to Seattle, though, your home turf.
My home turf, my stomping grounds. Legacy, though.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Legacy Grand Prix is a lot of fun, and I'm looking forward to it. I'm going to be playing Miracles is my plan right now.
Okay,
so
all right.
I'm going to go ahead and... you know, start practicing with that deck. I've already started just because that's a very hard deck to play. That's one of the more challenging decks I've ever played.
Yeah, the only Legacy deck that I've really played extensively is 12 Post. So I've heard good things about 12 Post versus Miracles. If we do end up playing each other, we'll see. We'll see how that goes.
I've heard you're a monster in the post.
Just ask Marshall about that.
Yep, I will. So it looks like the match is ready to go. So we're going to be heading down to the match here.
All right.
We've got Li Shitian on the bottom here. Kalastra Healers in indeed.
And one, man, if you get four of those back at once, all those triggers, woo.
Yeah, that is, you know, what you're looking for. We see Dave has a Dispel in hand, but we're going to get to take a look at all the hands once the sizes get adjusted. Because I don't see any lands in Dave's hand. If he's got if the last two cards in his hand are both lands, I could see his hand being decent.
Looks like Li Shitian took a mulligan, though, and I think this hand's a lot better. Turn 2 Jace is generally where you want to be no matter what deck you are in this format, I figured out.
Right, you can't... All right, so yeah, Dave has two lands there. You can't mulligan a hand of, you know, two land and a Jace on 6. Basically, no matter what the rest of the contents of the hand are.
I think I see a Flooded Strand and a Prairie Stream as Dave's two lands, and he drew a Hangerback Walker for the turn. Yeah. Dave's hand doesn't look that good to me, but
it's not. It's got the one of the key cards for the deck in Nissa, because that's apparently how they make sure they hit all their land drops. But if Dave doesn't draw a third land here, then he's just not going to do anything. This deck really does not do well if it misses land drops.
So what is David supposed to do to a Jace in this matchup? Does he just ignore it, or is he supposed to just go around it?
Well, what Dave's going to... I mean, ideally he silk wraps it, but given that he doesn't have the option here, he's just going to have to ignore it and hope that Li Shitian doesn't you know, go off too much with it. Dave did hit the forest, though. So Dave does get to play a turn 2 Hangerback Walker and then immediately run Nissa out on 3.
And I've seen some Hangerback Walkers do some real work in this deck. Again, with the Anthem effects, you can even play the Hangerback for X's 0. At some points, and just level it up if you need the mana.
I've got bad news for you, Kenji. It looks like they just revoked your Hall of Fame status here. So.
What is that?
you were listed as a you had a Hall of Fame tag for a little while.
Maybe I missed it. Oh shoot.
Maybe it was just a preview, you know.
Yeah. Minimum 15 years down the line.
And Jace doing what Jace does best in the stack, which just lets you hit your land drops, lets you make sure you have, you know, all gas. And Lee is gonna at least, you know, go up to three lands here. He can play a Nantuko Husk, and then if he draws a fourth land and can rally next, or a Collected Company next turn, then he's in very good shape. Yeah, it is a little awkward that he's got a Lenora Wayso, though. This is one of the reasons that we didn't play any Pain Lands, is that Pluto Delta has to get a basic here if he wants to play a Nantuko Husk, which means he's not going to have access to any white mana yet.
Gotcha. Yeah, no, that's a huge deal, the double white of Rally the Ancestor, which is generally cast for X equals 3, right, in this deck?
Yeah, sometimes you cast it for X equals 2 if you don't need if you don't have too many 3s. But yes, X equals 3 is by far the most common.
Okay. And Dave keeps hitting his land drops, it looks like. I mean, he's going to resolve that Nissa, like you said earlier, but he found another plane. So Wingmate Rock, he's going to have the mana for that.
So Dave has to decide now whether he wants to just keep Dispel up for Collected Company. And see, this is why I like the matchup from Rally's side. Imagine Dave does Dispel Collected Company. Jace can just flash it back, and Lee Shetan has another Collected Company. And then later a Rally. Like, Dave doesn't have 10 Dispels. He's got one. And the deck can just keep presenting threats. Though Lee's missing a land here. This is critical. This is how Dave gets into the game.
Yeah, and the nice thing for Lee Shetan, though, is that he can just play the Nantuko Husk and not, you know, leave it vulnerable to a Dispel, I suppose, if anything else.
Yeah, Husk is pretty immune to Dispel, I found. If I'm Dave, though, and Lee attacks here, I would snap off the block. So, yeah, Lee wisely didn't attack. Attacking into a 2-2 hanger back with a Husk there, just, it does not end well for you no matter what you do.
Mm. Now, how good is Secure the Waste? Again, we were talking about its blowout potential of doing it end of turn for, you know, even just a small amount, 3 or 4, and then being able to play that Retreat, play a Fetch or whatever, and pop it off. What turn do you look to play that card at the very earliest?
That is going to be pretty context-dependent. Basically, your ideal scenario is to just secure, untap, retreat, attack for lethal. But Dave is a few turns away from that at the very least. So what I expect Dave to do is get a forest here and then just play Flooded Strand. Just he wants to leave Dispel up. He did so last turn. He's going to leave it up this turn. And then I would imagine that we're going to see a next turn just pass maybe with secure up and then play secure end of turn. I don't know. It depends on what Lee does. The fact that Lee has a fourth land here has to make Dave a lot more worried about tapping out. So he doesn't really want to, you know, cast a Secure the Waste for the full amount end of turn, for example.
Yeah, especially a fetch at that, which is going to let Jace flip over if he wants to do that main phase here.
So yeah, Lee did choose to fetch first, which means Jace will flip if he uses Jace. But, you know, Jace is really interesting. You don't always want to flip Jace. Sometimes you'd want to just get an extra loot, and I'm actually not sure that Lee wanted to flip Jace here. It's a tough decision, since you're not interested in actually using Jace for anything. And notice Dave didn't activate the hanger back. He's leaving Dispel up for the max amount. So now he's going to go retreat, land. He's basically setting up a kill in two turns here.
So he's not even going to bother with the Wingmate Rock. He's just going to go for Secure the Wastes and then some Anthem effects.
That's what it's looking like, especially since he didn't want to tap out for Wingmate Rock this turn. I mean, Lee's going to get to resolve Collected Company. Between Jace, Company, and Second Company, one of those is going to resolve.
We're just seeing the power of Dispel in the standard format. We were talking about it the first match of tonight, you know, between Owen and Reed, how much work it did, and we see it's taking care of the Collected Company now. Lee is going to get to untap, and, you know, like you mentioned earlier, he can flashback the Collected Company if he wants.
Yeah, one of the cool things about this deck, too, is if you rally back a Jace, you can then flip Jace on your upkeep in response to the rally trigger, and Jace ends up staying in play as a Planeswalker, assuming you have enough cards in your graveyard.
That's actually really sick. So Jace has his double white, too.
Yeah, he's got everything he needs. So Jace flips here.
All right, so what do you do if you're in Lee's position?
I like flashing back rally, probably with the Jace here. I mean, you want to sack the Floodstrand before you rally, probably getting a Canopy Vista. Mm-hmm. And I like getting the value out of my Jace. I think I would -3. It's pretty close to whether you or sorry, Flashback Company. It's pretty close whether you Flashback Company off of Jace or off of your hand, or rather just cast it out of your hand. The other thing to think about is that, well, one advantage of waiting is that Dave has Wraths in his deck, so you could wait to try to play around like Planar Outburst, but I like this. I like minus three Jace, cast Collected Company.
Ooh, and we see a scary one coming into the battlefield. Zulport Cutthroat, in addition to the Cluster Healer. So not only are we going to get double ally triggers for Life Drain, that Cutthroat can do some serious work in conjunction with the Nantuko Husk and any other Recursion.
Yeah, and that is, those. I mean, those are Lee's kill mechanisms here. So Dave has to really watch out because Lee's now pretty close to just being able to rally for lethal. Let's see. It's not super close because right now Husk can eat three things, so he can drain for three, putting Dave to 14, and then Rally gets cast, and one, two, three, four things come into play, drain for two down to 12. So it's not that close, but I would expect after the second Collected Company, then the Rally will, in fact, be lethal. So Dave has to kill Lee before that happens. The difficulty there is that Claustra Healer and Zulaport Cutthroat do a really good job of blocking and gaining Lee a bunch of life.
Yeah, and if Lee's looking at David's decklist, he knows David's only running two dispels. The fact that he's already used one probably means he doesn't have another, so that Collected Company and Rally are probably going to resolve just fine.
Yeah, you can assume that, and you know, Lee is still in a spot where he's not even overextending if he does get something dispelled, especially if Jace ticks up to three. All of a sudden he can flash back a Rally, because Rally exiles itself, but if it gets countered and there's already one discarded, there's, you know, plenty for Jace to flash back.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, another cornerstone of the deck, Liliana on the draw for Lee Shitan.
Yeah, Liliana's got some good combos in this deck. Nantuko Husk and Sidisi's Faithful both let you flip Liliana pretty easily, and then you can start minusing Liliana to get creatures back.
Looks like that's what he's going to do. He's just going to... Oh, well, he had highlighted Liliana for a second there. He's going to weigh his options.
Collected Company is pretty appealing. I have to admit I would be tempted to do that. But Liliana's not bad either. Liliana, flip Liliana, get a zombie token, get Sidisi's Faithful back, and like bounce Hangar back Walker also seems pretty good. Because you only have to minus one Liliana to get back Sidisi's Faithful. It's pretty sweet.
I think this is pretty telling of a Secure the Wastes from David's side. Of course, we can see their opponent's hands, but...
Yeah, I think we're gonna do a good job of predicting Secure the Waste. But so is Lee, though. I mean, Lee sees that Dave has six mana on top, four cards in hand. It's not that hard to guess that.
Now, he hasn't used Jace this turn either, has he? I can't see if it's a
high. He has not. It's on two, so it's gonna tick up to three. I mean, there's no way Jace doesn't. And then the question is what do you plus Jace on? It doesn't matter too much. You've got so many blockers. Lee's basically looking whether he gets wants the guaranteed Liliana, which is decent, or the potential Collected Company, which could be better, but certainly could be worse because Company can miss. I mean, that is within the range of the card. And the fact that Lee has cards like Obzon Charm in his deck makes that more likely.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Lee is passing the turn here, so it looks like Collected Company is the plan. And it's going to be hard for Dave to win the game this turn, even with a bunch of Secure the Waste tokens.
Now, notably, Zulaport Cutthroat is not like Blood Artist. It's only when your creatures die are you going to get that trigger. But we might be seeing a lot of combat math here in the next few minutes.
Yeah, my guess is that Blood Artist was just a little too brutal. So they went with just looking at your side only. But it does mean in this particular case, even though Dave could do something like play Second Retreat, play a land, make all my tokens into 3/3s, that's not that close to lethal. Dave has eight attackers. Lee has four blockers, which already makes it not lethal. And then that doesn't even count what Collected Company hits, which is, you know, potentially a lot.
And even in a pinch, he could rally the Ancestors instead of using the Collected Company to gain some additional life.
Yeah, if you wanted to, that would be a very reasonable play from Lee's behalf. He just gets to sacrifice everything but one of the Nantuko Husks and then rally them all back and get a bunch of value. But given that he doesn't have to rally, I like Collected Company first here. So Dave's decision here, he's going to play a land. I mean, that part's not a debate, but do you play Retreat to give your whole team ++1, or do you just play a land, give your whole team ++1, attack with everything, then just play a Wingmate Rock post-combat? I think given that Dave can't deal lethal this turn, the Wingmate Rock does lead to the most damage next turn, because that's 10 in the air next turn.
Yeah. Now... is Lee going to be able to come back with lethal if David attacks with everything and just leaves the wingmate rock back? I guess that's not the case.
No, it looks like Dave is just straight up enabling raid here. He's just attacking with the 1-1, you know, core ally, and then it's going to get blocked by an Intuco Husk, and then Wingmate Rock's going to come down. And now I'd expect to see Lumbering Falls making a token instead. And that actually makes sense, because if Dave gave all his creatures plus and plus one, that wouldn't be quite enough to deal too much. Though actually, Nissa gets to flip here, so that's actually an additional wrinkle. You might as well plus one Nissa, or though you could put an Elemental into play and just have the most creatures possible for next turn.
Sure, just go a little bit wider, yeah. Looks like he's going to look at the top.
Yeah, I think Dave was just looking for that second Dispel there.
All right, Rock and its companion are going to hit the battlefield here. Now, Jace is going to be able to flashback any spell if Li Shitian does want to do that next turn. He can get, you know, another collected company.
So what Li is hoping here is that he goes end of turn company into enough gas to kill Dave with a rally, which would require a decent amount, but something like a Colostria healer and a second cutthroat would definitely do it.
So I see a Nantuko Husk and a land there. There's a second cutthroat.
A second cutthroat and a Sidisi's Faithful. And then the cutthroat triggers the Colostria healer because it's an ally. And then Sidisi's Faithful can bounce. If he wants, he can bounce one of his own allies to re-trigger the healer, but I could see just bouncing the Wingmate Rock token instead.
Sure. Each creature representing 2 damage, right, while each of the cutthroats, or I guess 2 life loss while each of the cutthroats is on the battlefield, though.
And I think this is
probably lethal.
Yeah, it looks pretty close, since the last creature standing doesn't drain, so because you can't sack everything at once, but that's already 2 down to 14 off just the Sidisi's Faithful, 2 off the healer down to 12, 2 off the redundant husk down to 10, 2 off a cutthroat down to 8, 1 off a cutthroat down to 7 once you sack the last
one. Rally it all back.
Then rally it all back, and it's way more than lethal here. Yeah. So Lee is going to get to advance to game 2, I guess, up a game.
He even has a little, I guess that's not exactly insurance. You end up sacking all your creatures, and if the rally gets countered, it doesn't do exactly what you want it to do.
No, and that's one reason, like you're just mentioning. Maybe just wait. The odds that Dave draws the Dispel on his turn aren't super high, and if you go for it right now and get your rally dispelled, you presumably die to Dave's attack, because Dave is representing a lot of damage.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what Lee decides here.
Because what Lee can do is just pass. When Dave attacks, just block 5 creatures and then go for the kill. And
sure.
You're giving Dave a look at 2 additional cards, 1 off his draw step, 1 off Nissa. But the upside is you don't die, and then you get, even if Dave has a counter spell, you just get to untap and rally again. It doesn't go wrong.
Rally the Ancestors. Who would have thought that was a constructed staple house these days, huh? What tier would you rate the rally deck, I guess?
Like on a, from a scale of like 1 to staple house, I would say that rally is like a tier 1.5 deck. The thing is, the reason that I didn't choose to play it in the Pro Tour is that you end up with a slightly bad matchup against Jeskai and not a great matchup against Mono Red. And I think the combination of those two things, plus the weakness to Anafenza, just means that it's got a lot of vulnerabilities. The upside of rally, though, is that against decks like this, the one that Dave's playing, you can almost never lose. It is very difficult to lose to, like, Green-White Megamorph, for example.
All right, Li Shitian is going to go with the Liliana play here. Somebody noted in chat that, yeah, Wingmate Rock is going to gain some amount of life, but with this many creatures on Li Shitian's battlefield, I don't know if that's even going to be enough.
I don't think that would have changed much, no. Like, the Liliana does... Or, sorry, the Wingmate Rock would gain Dave 8 life, and that would not be enough to save Dave from the second rally, because Lee could just rally again. Mm-hmm. Like each rally does a ton of damage right now.
Actually, we didn't consider this, but the Liliana route plays around the Dispel, and is that lethal? Let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8. It's not quite lethal, but...
Let's see, so CC's Faithful is bouncing here. 10, 8, 6, 4. No, see, that is not quite lethal with the Sidisi's Faithful. It does play around to Dispel, but It's again setting Lee up to win next turn, because it doesn't look like to me like it wins this turn.
And actually, Lee played it really safe. He bounced the Wingmate Rock with the Sidisi's Faithful trigger, thereby negating any life that David would have gotten from it attacking.
Yeah.
I didn't see what the Jace Plus done, but I guess that's pretty irrelevant here.
Hanger Backwalker.
Okay.
So what can Dave draw here to get out of this? Because he's very close to dead just on board, and then next turn Liliana getting back like a Colostria healer should do enough to deal lethal without having to even cast Rally. And then, yeah, I don't think Dave can draw a card that, like, even a fetch land to go with that Retreat to Emeria, I just don't think does the trick.
Yeah, he's got Planar Outburst, but again, he doesn't want to do that. Silkwrap, Stasis Snare.
There's the Dispel.
Okay. Well, it's definitely a good start, but...
But the way Lee's set it up, So the advantage of Lee's line is that he just doesn't care about Dispel. I think I would have still gone for the Rally just because it does so much damage and you don't lose to a Dispel anyway, but Lee is definitely playing it safe, and the fact that Dave drew the Dispel, it means that, you know, Lee's not really that concerned with it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's actually...
Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, I was going to say it's actually just a dead draw for Dave if Lee's not on the Rally plan.
Yeah, he can just bounce or return back the Sidisi's Faithful, the second one in the graveyard, with Liliana. Now that David doesn't have any flying creatures. I saw some lists running Valorous Stance, the Bant tokens list running Valorous Stance to kill their own hanger back as a pseudo secure the wastes. I thought that was kind of interesting. I don't think... Mr. Williams has that in his deck, but... Oh, he's three in the sideboard.
So, Dave's going to play Retreat and then plus Nissa and hope to hit, like, a fetch land or something like that. Well, he hit a land. It wasn't a fetch land. So he's going to make all his creatures into 5/5s, but that's just not going to be that close to lethal. Mm-hmm. I guess what this could do is it's possible that Dave forces Lee Shi Tian to chump enough with enough creatures... that Lee then is forced to rally next turn, maybe? Is that accurate? Let's see. 7 attackers, and they all are 5 power, but Lee only has to block, like, 2 of them and then sack one of the, you know, like the Sidisi's Faithful to gain 2 life to go to 27, and then take 25 going to 2.
Yeah, just get out of range, yep.
Yeah, this is going to be tough. I mean... And then Lee also just has the option of attacking with Nantuko Husk, and that just does a million damage, too. Plus, you know how we were talking earlier about how Nantuko Husk can't kill everything simultaneously, then if Lee goes and just blocks 5 creatures and just passes priority, all 5 creatures die, all of his creatures die at once, and that just puts 10 Zulaport Cutthroat triggers on the stack immediately.
Yep.
So, Dave is between a rock and a hard place, and I don't see how he gets out of this very easily.
I think he's got a hope for a mistake from Lee Shi Tian at this point.
Yeah. Thing is, Dave's dead on board if he just passes, but he's also dead on board if he attacks. So, that's usually not, like, words you want to hear.
I think you have to go for the attack, though, right? Because Lee Shi Tian's going to see it on his turn at the very least, right?
Yeah, presumably you could just attack with everything and hope Lee just doesn't block or something along those lines.
So he could be... So Stasis Snare is something that Dave could have in his hand to make Lee not, you know, just pentablock.
Yeah, Stasis Snare. If Lee blocks with everything and Dave... The problem is, so from Lee's perspective, right, he blocks with everything. Dave goes, Stasis Snare, get your Zulaport Cutthroat. I don't die. Then Lee goes, all right, untap, rally the ancestors.
Kill you.
Because Dave's then tapped out. Yeah, I mean, Lee definitely has to consider these things. It's just, I don't see how Dave gets himself out of this.
I'm just trying to give him the benefit of the doubt, even if he's just dead.
No, it's very good to look it out and... So sometimes, you know, you can win hopeless games just because you figure out that maybe your opponent will just do, like, 5 things wrong, but it's just unlikely to happen here.
4/5/5s isn't going to do the trick here, but...
No, and if Lee just take... I guess if we can take a look, maybe they're attacking the planeswalkers. Well, they're all getting blocked. So actually, yeah, they were attacking the planeswalkers, but they're all getting blocked. So it doesn't too matter too much. So Dave, at this point, is going to 2.
It's going to lose 8 life.
If combat just resolves. And then, well,
actually,
this actually puts Li Shitian in a position where he takes Dave to 2 and then untaps and uses, all right, this is better. This.
Yes.
Well, this actually still doesn't.
2, 4, 6, 8.
The risk there is that if Li blocks with 4 creatures, takes Dave to 2, he then doesn't have lethal with just Liliana, is relying on Rally, and that actually could potentially not work.
So it's interesting, because he was playing around the Dispel, like you mentioned earlier, but now it seems like he's going, well, if he makes those blocks, he's going to play with the Rally.
Though what he could do is he can sacrifice, like he can block with both husks and then sacrifice 2 things to one of the husks, making it survive. Sure. Sacrificing CeCe's Faithful and Antuco Husk to Husk, having it survive. And then you end up with Husk Cutthroat in play. You also don't need to block all the soldiers. Like, it's not mandatory that you do that. Certainly don't want to double block any of the soldiers, because then that just gives Dave more options. You're not forced to kill everything.
This is kind of interesting to see. All right, so he finally offs on just blocking 2 of the soldiers. We're going to get 4 triggers. Dave's going to fall to 6, and yeah. That should do it, Liliana. Oh, looks like Dave was attacking Jace with one of those, or at least a few of those tokens. But now Dave's just dead on board.
Yeah, so now Dave's at 6. Liliana can get back Colostra Healer that puts Dave to 5. Sack Healer go to 3. Sack Cutthroat go to 1. Sack Nintuko Husk or Cutthroat go to 0. And then regardless, and then you have Rally just in case Dave has something.
That was actually a little bit closer than it might have seemed at first. It was just that turn late dispel and I guess the double Cutthroat off of the collected companies.
No, but I guess the block with 4 lets you sack the non-blocking husk, is what people are saying in chat, so that actually works too. Either way, Lee just had a ton of options as to what would work here.
Huh.
So he's opting to rally here. But the thing is, yeah, even if this rally gets countered, he still has lethal.
So what's the benefit of waiting until Dave's turn to sacrifice his creatures?
Well, I guess Lee wanted to see if Rally resolved. The only downside to that is now that Dave has more than 3 mana, Dave could have like a Stasis Snare, but the Stasis Snare actually doesn't even break this up anyway. So yeah, I don't think that Dave has a way out of this. Just he is dead on board if Lee sacrifices things, you know, in the right order, which is basically just Colostra Healer followed by Cutthroat followed by anything.
Mm-hmm.
Since I don't think Dave has any incidental life gain in his deck, taking a look at the deck list here.
Just the Wingmate Rock, but that's in his hand.
Right.
I don't like some people in chat saying Lee played around a Stasis Snare, but again, he can just sacrifice the creatures in response.
Yeah.
I mean, he's going to have to do it here now with the Silk Wrap.
Yeah, there's nothing Dave can have in his deck, and we have deck lists too. So, and then on the board there, unless Dave had, you know, a way to gain life in play, or like, it, you know, as instant speed, it wouldn't work though. Yes, if Dave, someone said if Dave had Blighted Step, that would be pretty funny.
I expect to see a large number of triggers go on the stack here.
Yep. Dave goes to 1 if you sack the other Cutthroat here, and then Dave goes to 0 when you sack either creature.
Ping, ping, ping. Gotta assume Cutthroat is just one of the most important pieces of the deck to get. And
It certainly is.
Yeah, they're running Evolutionary Leaps, I believe, in the sideboard. Oh, maybe that was a different deck that list that was bringing up. I've seen some lists with Evolutionary Leap in them, but I suppose the four-color one, it doesn't want to hurt its mana base so hard with the green activation cost.
No, Lee's sideboard is Duress, Anafenza, Felidar Cub, Balorous Dance, and Arashan Cleric.
Those Felidar Cubs are going to be nice versus all of the Retreat to Marias and even the Silk Wraps, potentially.
They could be, but, you know, honestly, I don't even know if you want to board them in. Like, you could because they kill Silk Wrap, but you don't really care about that very much. I guess it's better than maybe some of your other, like, kind of medium creatures. Like, Sidisi's Faithful is not all that impressive, but in general, I don't think Lee needs too much. Maybe a couple Duresses to stop Dispels.
Seems good. Trigger's still going on the stack here. And there we go. All right,
there we go.
Like how we can see their sideboarding options in real time. It's quite nice.
Yeah, that's a nice little upgrade here.
All right, so you said Duress potentially coming in for Li Shitian. What about Dave? What does he have that he's going to bring in here?
He's got Dispel, and the rest is largely irrelevant. Like, he can board in, look, some number of Evolutionary Leap if he wants to, a way to sacrifice Hangarback Walker to start to fly over, because he's just got so many cards that aren't that great. But Dispel is really the card you're looking at. So Lee's got a couple options here. And, you know, he's got some amount of value he can bring in. Like, again, Duress is just good against Dispel. So Dave already done sideboarding because he's not really changing almost anything.
Well, actually, I saw him take out all of his Gideons, though.
Huh. Yeah, I mean, I that doesn't surprise me. Gideon is pretty slow. It feels like you're not going to end up doing a ton with it here.
Okay. And over on Li Shitian's side, I see Bring Delight still in there. Yeah. Gotta love that card.
It hit the sideboard for a second, and then it came back, so.
Anything else you might add? Doesn't really look like it.
Right now he trimmed a Rally, which makes sense because Rally is the card you don't really want to draw multiples of in general, and also gets hit by Dispel. Since Lee can, I mean, if you saw that game, Lee won without casting Rally at all. I mean, mm-hmm. It got dispelled, but it didn't matter. It could have just as well not gone on the stack, so. I think it's not necessary to have it.
Looks like Lee only has a one left hand, but we can't see that seventh card quite yet. Hopefully he's got a black source there. Definitely looks like a keep. Llanowar right. Wastes, all right.
Yeah, that's not bad, because you can get like Prairie Stream with the Windswept Teeth and then go Llanowar Wastes into whatever it is you want. Dave has another two-lander here, but this time he's got double Elvish Visionary to get to three, so I certainly think a keeper.
Telling by the art, it looks like a Wingmate Rock on the very far left hand.
Oh, I'm going to go with Quarantine Field.
All right, you got me. Can you see it better than I can?
No, I'm just good at recognizing art.
Oh, fair.
It's one of my only skills.
Okay. Somebody has an HOF next to their name. It was stolen from me.
Yeah. It's Hall of Fine Art.
Where's my Chion ranking? That's what I need.
Yeah, you're what, like number four, maybe five?
I think I was two last time I checked. It's too hard to beat Kyle. It's too hard to beat Kyle.
So, yeah, I would imagine both players are keeping their hands here. And it's Dave's turn right now. We'll see what he ends up doing. Obviously, he's going to lead with Lumbering Falls. I think they're just waiting to begin here.
Seems like a good start. Now, do you just play the hanger back on turn two? That makes sense to me. I guess if you have a Nissa in your hand, you want to hit the land drop on time.
Well, it's going to depend on your second draw step here. If Dave draws a land, then yeah, you can just play Hangarback on two, Nissa on three. But if Dave misses like you did, you've got to play Elvish Visionary. You've got to just flood his Strand for a Plains and just drop Elvish Visionary.
I know Sam Black was talking a lot about the Elvish Visionary, just making sure you hit your land drops. Is it that important that you put a Visionary in your deck over, say, something else? I don't know what other two drop you might put in, but
Presumably, because the idea is that you need to hit your land drops, but you can't just play 30 land, and you also want to do something with your mana on turn two. And Elvish Visionary does block. It does activate Evolutionary Leap, and in general, it's, I think, worth having.
Okay, fair enough. Well, he hasn't hit a third land yet, but he drew a rally for the turn. Oh, I couldn't see that off his hand. It looks like he drew a Prairie Stream. Or, sorry, Land of War Wastes, of course. He played the Prairie Stream turn one.
Yeah, and he's got Sunken Hollow as his third land. So Lee's lands are going to come to play tap. So are Dave's. Both these players are going to be, you know, not hitting three mana on turn three. So now Lee should sacrifice the cub here to put it in the graveyard.
Mm-hmm.
But Dave might as well play the Silk Wrap because that cub is stopping it no matter what.
Yeah, pretty nice the cub synergy with the rally, similar to, you know, Jace getting back with Ojitai's Command type effect.
So now Lee, since he drew Bloodstained Mire, he actually can, if he wants, have three mana this turn. He can Duress, take the Quarantine Field as his really only option. One of the keys with Duress, though, post-board, is sometimes you just want to wait till they, just to give them a higher chance of drawing Dispel, because you don't care about too many cards they have. But in this case, since Lee doesn't have Collected Company, his draw is going to be a little slow. Lee's not very close to doing anything. He's just going to play a Husk, a Cutthroat, and an O4. So I think that Lee's going to Duress. He didn't want Dave to play like a Retreat to Emeria and start putting a clock on.
Sure, yeah. And this still lets him use his mana efficiently. He can play the Cutthroat if he wants to, as opposed to playing the Husk this turn off of the fetch.
Right, he can Bloodstained Mire for a Swamp and play a Zulaport Cutthroat, which I imagine is what he's going to be doing now. Also, Bloodstained Mire can't get white sources no matter what, so there's no reason to wait on that one.
Sure, yeah. Ooh, a Wingmate Rock off the top for Dave.
That was a good draw, because Wingmate Rock gives Dave some actual pressure. The way Dave's going to win is by putting a clock on Lee. The way that Dave's not going to win is by trying to, like, control Lee and just dispel his rallies, because if you're not killing him, eventually Lee's just going to assemble the wimp.
Mm-hmm. And this guaranteeing that Dave here is going to have his fifth land.
Definitely. I'd crack with Elvish Visionary, too. Why not?
Oh, yeah. No, Cutthroat's super annoying. You want to get that off the battlefield.
So Lee's really looking to draw Collected Company here. He can't cast it this turn, but Liliana's actually a really good substitute. Because given that Lee has Rally, what he's really looking for is just more action. Collected Company's action, because it's, you know, often two creatures, and Liliana's action, because Liliana's also multiple creatures, multiple Zulaport triggers, does some nonsense with Sidisi's Faithful.
Ooh, a good draw from Dave here with the Dispel. I still think he's probably going to go lead with the Wingmate Rock here. Is he too scared of Li Shitian's board at the moment?
I don't think so, and even though Collected Company would be annoying, and Lee couldn't have played it last turn, if you notice, Lee played a tapped land, mm-hmm. I think Dave's just going to slam Rock. I mean, Dave knows that you can't win this game by trying to grind Lee out. His deck is just so much better designed for that. But I guess he's playing around Collected Company. I think if Lee had an untapped land last turn, Dave would have been a lot more likely to tap out for Wingmate Rock.
Yeah, fair enough. That Sunken Hollow making it so Lee couldn't play the Liliana plus Sidisi if he wanted to bounce and get the Planeswalker immediately.
Unfortunately for Dave, even if Lee does end up, you know, not finding too much here, Sidisi's Faithful plus Liliana is actually a really good combo, and I can imagine Dave getting, you know, his Wingmate Rock bounced over and over again.
Wow, Li Shitian with a huge draw in Duress. That's going to, you know, be a nice lead up into the Rally of the Ancestors, getting rid of that Dispel from Dave.
And now that Lee knows Dave's hand, you know, I guess at this point he only knows the Canopy Vista, I think. So given that, I would still imagine Lee's going to hold on to the Duress until the turn, like, before he wants to cast Rally or the turn he casts Rally, mm-hmm. just because at this point he's into, like, get Dispel mode.
Yep. And he's got an active Planeswalker now once this Sidisi's Faithful goes to the graveyard.
Yeah, Sidisi's Faithful is going to sacrifice. It's going to bounce. I would imagine Hangerback Walker, trigger Liliana, trigger Zulaport Cutthroat, get a 2-2, flip Liliana. Then Liliana can immediately get back Sidisi's Faithful, though I don't even know if Lee's really all that interested in that, given that bouncing Elvish Visionary and Nissa is not super productive.
So do you not use anything on Liliana then? Because you don't want to discard either Rally or Duress.
Yeah, I could see getting back the Sidisi's Faithful.
Or maybe the Cub. The Cub
and just not
back.
Bouncing. Or yeah, we're getting back Cub and putting Liliana down to one. So Dave's going to trade two Elvish Visionaries for a zombie token here.
looks to be the case. That cutthroat seems so inconsequential, but just slowly and surely.
Yeah, it's even in a game that's not really leading to a combo finish yet, it's still, you know, pinging in here and there, and that is very valuable.
I have to assume Dave feels actually a little bit decent, though. He gets to attack in with Nissa next turn, play the Wingmate Rock, and still hold Dispel. That's not awful.
And Nissa attacking is one good reason to get back City Seas Faithful to block, or, you know, bouncing Nissa to make it so Wingmate Rock isn't a big play. That's not irrelevant either.
Sure, yeah. We'll see what Li Shitian wants to do here. Remember, this is only turn five. A lot of things are going on.
Dave did weaken his Wingmate Rock with that double block because he got two of his own creatures off the board. And now if Lee just bounces Nissa, which, again, a little unconventional to bounce a creature with a good end of battlefield effect. If Lee just bounces Nissa, then all of a sudden Dave doesn't have a kicked Wingmate Rock.
Yeah. And you know what? Nantuka Husk has the potential to deal a lot of damage this turn.
Yeah, Nantuka Husk next turn, if Lee draws a white source, could be close to lethal off rally, but Lee is just going to go with the 0-4 blocker, the steel wall.
Gotcha. Unfortunately, not enabling any metalcraft this time. All right, so Nissa's going to get in. I assume we're going to see that Wingmate Rock holding up the Dispel. But that Duress is doing overtime work here.
Yeah, Duress is going to be good. It's going to eventually answer that Dispel. Though that Dispel is, I mean, that Rally is not really going to do anything that soon here. Lee's got probably another turn or two before he even wants to cast it.
Mm-hmm. Wingmate Rock, of course, going to gain Dave some life if he survives any amount of time.
Yeah, so Lee just hoping to hit Collected Company. I guess the problem is on four land, he can't Company and Duress in the same turn, but here's a Colostro Healer.
That is not awful, although it's super awkward that Lee can't actually plus Liliana without getting rid of the Rally. I guess maybe he just gets rid of the Colostro Healer, if he wants to do it that way, but because that means both of the the flyers have to attack.
Yeah, what I think Lee's going to do is this. He's going to sacrifice Faithful to Husk and then minus one Liliana to get back Faithful, bounce the Wingmate Rock token.
Okay.
And then Lee ends up losing Liliana that way, but I think it ends up being a little better for him than having two Wingmates in play.
Sure, great call, yeah. And that looks like what's going to happen here. And Wingmate Rock is going to be able to attack in for at least four damage, I think. He did sacrifice something, right?
I think he's going to. He has not decided which one to sacrifice. Nantukosk is also like pretty reasonable here. Drawing that Colostro Healer was decent, though Lee would like to draw white source. Basically, Lee's dead draws right now are Duresses, Rallies, and lands that don't produce white. So it's possible for Lee to miss here. This isn't like last game. Last game, Lee had a ton of cards in his hand and in the long game could never lose. He had so many options. This game, Lee could hit a bunch of like low impact draws, another Felidar Cub, for example, and end up losing the game. I think Dave's got to just take the hit off Husk here.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that close to lethal either. It's at 9. Because Dave gets to flip Nissa now, gain a life off the Wingmate Rock. He can actually attack with both first to get the extra life off the Nissa attacking. I like that.
Yeah, no, that's sweet.
And I would send the Wingmate at the Liliana. You're not that close to killing Li Shitian here.
Who is also notably off double white, like you mentioned earlier.
Yeah, and so Dave's certainly aware of that. I think I wouldn't be surprised if Dave put Lee on having Rally as his last card, just because that's one of the few cards Lee wouldn't be able to cast right now.
Ooh, Nissa hitting Silkwrap is huge.
Yeah, Silkwrap is not bad. With the Husk out, it's annoying that Lee gets to just put his creature in the graveyard instead. But you can still get, like, for example, Husk or Cutthroat off the board and at least force Lee to have the Rally, which Rally doesn't look quite lethal yet. It's going to get, let's see, 1, 2, healers 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, it's actually getting really close. Rally might be lethal with Liliana's flipping.
Yeah, that is really, really close. Because remember, Liliana's not only going to produce a creature, but she can get a creature back.
Lee just F6'd, and I know you're a fan of the F6, but that Nantuko has vanished forever.
Whoa.
It got Silkwrapped. granted, Lee has a Felidar Cup in his graveyard, so it's not the end of the world, but that gives up a trigger off Zulaport Cutthroat right now. It also means that the rally, you have to sack the Cub first. That, I mean, that could potentially be a problem for Lee here.
Who needs a white anyways to be able to cast the rally.
Right. Yeah. He also needs a white source. This is a four-color deck. Sometimes you don't have double white.
We'll see what Lee hits.
A second rally. So, I mean, I said that this is the blueprint for Dave to, you know, to win here. It's Lee just hitting brick after brick, and now the husk plant, the husk not sacrificing itself, is cascading into more of a problem, because now Dave can stasis near the Zulaport Cutthroat, and then Felidar Cub can only get one of the two back, which means rally just no longer lethal.
Yeah, Dave's going to only attack in with the Wingmate Rock here and probably level up his hangar backs, but. You know, an untouched Nissa, Stasis Snare on the Zulaport Cutthroat, which he can do at instant speed.
Yeah, I think Dave is actually in good shape now.
Oh, how the tides have turned. Or as Coverage likes to say, turned the corner. Chat, please. Do you just pop it off now, or do you wait?
I would wait until Lee's upkeep, because you want to play around a collected company. There's a chance Lee has collected company, and Lee didn't. So Dave's just going to wait now. I guess you could respond to Husk anyway, and you can still respond to Zulaport Cutthroat, so, or just let it resolve, because it's not a sacrifice effect.
Yeah, that Silkrup getting that noon Tuco Husk, like you said, is just snowballing out of control now. Dave in pretty good spot. He's going to need to top deck not only a white source, but what, another Cub or another Husk?
Yeah, just some action. Lee at this point, his rallies are just not doing anything. Like, even if he was able to cast one, it wouldn't be insane. So you would say that Dave's now, turned the corner on this game, or maybe turned the snowball on this game. He's really just getting farther and farther ahead. our producer liked that one. She thought it was very good.
All I know is that Lee Shi Tian has not turned the corner, but he's ran into a brick wall.
Yeah.
That's all I know.
Yeah, Dave has all the momentum right now. Lee isn't able to punch through that brick corner with his momentum.
C+. I'll give you a C+ for that one.
All right. Well, this is one of the cards Lee could draw to get him out of this. I mean, this melts the snowball. He's able to collect a company and do some really good hits here.
This might turn into a one-way street after all. You never know.
Yeah.
Is that the Blighted Woodland? Oh, it is. Nissa has just been bricking. Oh, okay, not now, but Nissa kept hitting lands there for a while.
It's true, but yeah, that stopped. And now that City's Just Faithful has prevented a lot of damage. I think that it would be a lot harder for Lee to survive this long if that 0-4 wasn't there brick walling the hangar back walker.
All right, looks like Stasis Snare is going to come out, take out. Oh, no, he's just activating the Lumbering.
Yeah, Lumbering falls. I mean, you could wait, especially since Lee did end up drawing the Collected Company, the card I think Dave would be most concerned with.
Sure.
So now Lee is probably going to cast it. You might end up with a good block here. Oh no, Lee's just gonna, he's content just to block, he's gonna company end of turn.
Looks like he's gonna throw his cutthroat in front of the hangar back.
Though you'd want a company before combat damage resolves, at the very least, try to hit a second cutthroat.
Yeah, that would make sense.
You could also just take the 6 down to 4 here, company end of turn, and maybe try to like spike double husk into rally into, you know, miracle win.
It's very possible. Again, that Stasis Snare hitting that Nantuko Shade is, or Nantuko Husk rather, is coming back to haunt him.
Yeah, I don't know if that would have ended up making the difference here. Basically, the way that really impacts the game will be if Lee does end up casting a rally. Because if this game does come down to rally, not having the Husk in the graveyard is a very big difference. Because then the Felidar Cub could just get back the cutthroat.
I see Liliana and some unknowns here, but it does look like he has multiple hits.
Liliana Husk is really what you're going for, because if you hit Liliana plus just like another creature, then Dave has the option of Stasis Snaring the Liliana right away.
It looks like Li Shitian either has some options or... Sorry, go ahead.
All right, so Li's got some options. Sounds like Liliana, Nantuko Husk, and Sadisi is Faithful.
And those were two of the cards that you mentioned what he needs here to get back into this game.
It's possible that Li goes with the Faithful, which I think is very reasonable here because it does answer some of Dave's like flying threat, like Wingmate, which would be lethal. But Dave can now Stasis Snare in response. He could actually hit the Liliana, but or he could hit the Sadisi's Faithful, because if you get the Faithful off the board, then the sacrificing doesn't matter that much because it doesn't trigger exploit.
Yep. Something we all know too well from those limited days of killing the exploit creature in response.
Yeah.
Granted, Li Shitian has the option then to not exploit the creature.
Right. So Dave's not going to have lethal next turn. Well, that's actually not true, because Dave's just going to have four attackers or three attackers to Lee's two blockers, so Lee needs to draw something here. Mm-hmm. Though I guess going up to four means one of the hangarbacks isn't lethal.
Actually, none of the creatures on board or on the battlefield are lethal anymore.
Yeah. So Lee's still looking for a second white source.
And the answer is... Don't slow roll. Actually... That might not be bad.
Felidor Cub is certainly reasonable, because this is one of the ways that Li can actually cascade into a really good rally. Mm-hmm. Cub, live another turn, get back, you know, like Husk, or unlock the Husk from the Silk Wrap. Then you get to rally back Cub to kill the other two enchantments. Does Nissa's lethal ultimate let you attack immediately? Let's just take a look.
I don't believe that you get haste off of that.
Oh, actually, never mind. It just untaps the land. So yeah, Nissa's ultimate is just lethal here.
Huh. But Li just scooped, I guess?
Yeah, because Nissa's ultimate is lethal.
Oh, okay. I see.
It just makes the lands in play into 6/6s. So, bam.
Gotcha.
All right, well, Dave managed to steal one, and the way he did it was Li just drawing multiple copies of Rally and... basically not being able to get anything going. Though I would imagine, again, Li is favored in most, you know, games of that length.
Yeah, no, that's what I found really surprising, that the game went super long, which generally would favor Li Shitian, we think. But, you know, he bricked off. He didn't hit his second white source. He missed accidentally the trigger on the Husk, and Dave was able to just get advantage and overrun him.
And given that Li never drew the second white, I don't think that sacrificing the Husk or not would have ended up deciding that game.
Sure. Both players look so happy on their little infographs or whatever.
I'd say Dave looks happier.
He does look happier. I'm not sure the exact scenarios of that, but...
That was at, I think, one of the team GPs, perhaps GP San Jose, which they ended up... Well, the first team GP San Jose, which they ended up winning, as opposed to the second, which they got second, because their record in San Jose is just great.
Fair enough.
I would say both players' hands are between a 5.5 and a 6 on the 10 scale here. They're just not that exciting, but I think Lee's is certainly keepable. Dave's actually could say mulliganing. It just doesn't do anything. It's turn 3 Den Protector, turn 4 Secure into maybe a Wingmate. I mean, I wouldn't begrudge him for keeping it, certainly, but this can't be one of the hands Dave's is excited about.
No, it looks like he did keep it, but it just has no interaction with Li Shitian's plan, and you know, that's what he's looking for.
Well, meanwhile, Lee's got Colostria Healer into Grim Horrorspecs into Liliana, but what he's missing is a sacrifice outlet, either a Faithful or a Husk. I still don't understand Li not playing four Husks. As someone who's played this deck a lot, I just cannot imagine that. But that's how I guess you make room for four Colostria Faithful here, or Colostria Healer, rather.
Does he have any other good sacrifice outlets? I don't, besides like the Faithful.
There just aren't any. I mean, we looked at all of the ones that you could get into play. You know, off of a collected company.
Yeah. It looks like Dave drew another land for the turn. Forest.
So Dave's decision here is, does he play Lumbering Falls, which comes into play tapped always, or Canopy Vista? The advantage of playing Vista, even though that does coming to play tapped. Like, as you see, he played it, even though it does come to play on tap later, is if he draws a Silk Wrap, he gets to cast it on turn two.
Ah, that makes perfect sense.
Which is what I think Dave's plan is here.
Flooded Strand off the top for Lee Shitian, whose hand is not progressing very well.
No, he's got the white sources, and the black sources, and the green sources, and the blue sources. He needs the, you know, creature sources. Collected Company is secretly just the card that's the most important of the deck. I mean, the deck wouldn't exist without Rally exactly, but there we are.
Yeah, he called it.
Yeah, that is not good news for Dave, because Collected Company is what gives you the critical mass to win the game, whether it's via Rally or just via just cards in play.
So do you lead with Harris Specs or Liliana then if you're going to make this? Oh, he actually played...
Given he played Windswept Peak, he's definitely playing Harris Specs.
All right. I guess you don't want to play Liliana until you can... Or you already have a Sacrifice outlet, maybe?
Yeah.
Because it leaves it in range of Silk Wrap.
As I said often during testing, Dave has high hopes and grim horror expectations for this game.
That was better. A-. I'll give you an A- on that one. I'm a tough sell. I can't quite see what Dave... It looks like he drew a Flooded Strand for the turn. Face down Den Protector. Not exactly where he wants to be for turn three. So do you just pop off the Collected Company now to play around Dispel?
Oh, yeah. I think that there's basically nothing that can punish you for playing it now, and a lot that can punish you for playing it later.
We're getting a word from chat from Paul, who says that you use that joke 50 times during testing. I might have to lower my grade a little bit to B+ if that is the case.
It was new to you. I'll stand by the A.
Okay. The chat seems to agree. Collected Company, what does he hit?
At least a Liliana.
Whoa.
Yeah, just everything.
Yeah, just so, the world.
I would imagine Liliana plus Nantuko Husk is coming into play here, though the Lee does have the option of Zulaport Cutthroat as well. I guess you can play three Husks if you just hit one off Company every time.
Hey, yeah. So he's going to get to draw a card, he's going to get to flip Liliana, he's going to get a zombie token, he's going to get to use Liliana. Wow.
Yeah, this is the strength of Liliana here. When your cards are all working together, Liliana does a lot. And it's like turn three, and I don't see how Dave can, you know, win this game already. It's going to be very difficult for him.
Mm-hmm. Especially with the handicap. Like, Secure the Wastes, he can chump for a few turns, but even then, there's the engine is already rolling. It's a turn late here for Dave.
And this is part of, you know, the strength of the Rally deck is that there's no rallies will be cast or resolve in any of the games Lee wins in this match, I believe. I think there's a pretty good chance that Lee just wins two games where rallies never happen.
Yeah. Again, and, like you said, Collected Company being the more important card potentially.
Yeah, Collected Company is what gets you, in this case, 6 mana worth of creatures for 4 mana here. And a 2-for-1. Like, Dave can play Nissa, he can leave up mana for Secure, and... getting good beats on the chat, but that...
I know.
Hey, I set myself up. As usual. In a game like this, like, Dave's options just can't beat a fair game, and Lee's still got an unfair game kind of in his back pocket here.
Yep. All right, looks like Dave's just going to pass the turn holding up that Secure the Wastes. And Lee Shitian's got to be feeling pretty good about his position, and another Grim Harrow Specs off the top means he's going to be able to draw 2 cards off of each of the non-tokens being sacrificed if he wants to.
And he can even, like, plus the Liliana because he's got plenty of lands to discard.
And that is, in fact, what he does here. Discarding looks like he's going to discard the Llanowar Wastes. Dave can do nothing but sit back and weep, I suppose.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot he can do. Because... he didn't draw any of his low drops like Stasis Snare or Silk Wrap that can interact with creatures, so Lee's engine here is just, like, fully going off.
Looks like Lee comfortable here, almost making a full-out attack. He's aware fully of the secure the waist, but again, with the double Grim Harris specs and Tuco Husk.
Yeah, I mean, there's a chance that Colostria Healer was getting sacrificed regardless of what Dave does for in terms of blocking, so it makes sense that Lee would just attack with it.
I don't think I've been too impressed by the Colostria Healer in this list so far, but it's done some work.
No, I think that Colostria Healer is just not really necessary. I don't think it helps you in the games you're losing, just the games you're winning.
Looks like your list is more... a lot more four ofs in your list. The Catacomb Sifter, I think, is the best one there, man. That scry is so nice.
I really like Catacomb Sifter because it's a combination of Grim Horror specs in that scrying to rally your company is the same as drawing in a lot of cases, and it gives you two blockers for the price of one. So it just gives you more triggers off Cutthroat. It just provides, you know, ways to stop your opponent from killing you. It makes Husk better. So I think Catacomb Sifter is great. I would definitely play four. That being said, none of these differences are what matters if me and Lee end up playing each other. It's just really an offense.
And you actually don't have any of those in your sideboard. Lee has, how many did you say? Three. Wow. Yeah.
Two, I think.
It says three on this on the sideboard.
Oh, he has three? Well, that's even worse for me.
Is he on the same side of the bracket with you? If he wins here and you win, you play each other for sure? Okay.
Yep. I still have to win. It looks like... Huh. Oh, yeah, that is three in Offensa. That sucks. I was hoping it was a misclick. Are you sure it wasn't an Offensa Kintree Spirit? Because I would allow that.
Not quite, unfortunately. Not quite. All right. So, pretty obvious attack here from Dave means that the Wingmate Rock is almost certainly coming down. But at this point, you know, Lee can find... numerous amount of cards to basically just win the game. And with Jace, he can dig a little deeper and even flashback the collected company. I think he hit two Zulaput Cutthroats in the first collected company, so he's less likely to hit one unless he's fetched.
Yeah, he sacked a Delta since then. And I think we're going to see Jace flashing back. Well, we're just drawing company, you know,
sure.
Same thing.
Sure.
and then you get to... basically, if you find... one Zulaput Cutthroat will be lethal, but... Two looks like it just about would be. And especially you get back Colostria Healer. Yeah.
Yeah, and the Liliana hasn't been used yet, so.
Yeah.
Let's see what he hits.
And that Wingmate Rock is just not going to pressure Lee enough. His engine basically means that if Lee doesn't have lethal this turn, he's almost assuredly going to have lethal next turn.
Actually, he can, like, Lee can also sacrifice or bring back the healer right now, sacrifice it to the husk, draw two additional cards to find a cutthroat if he needs to.
Yeah, or a rally. But given that he's just, you know, looking for cutthroat now, then I think that makes sense just to company first.
Sure. So DC, Liliana, Jace are the hits here.
Yeah, and again, this isn't exactly lethal, but Lee's going to draw enough cards that he might get close to it. He can get, like... CC's faithful, sack it to draw two cards, bounce a wingmate, and then Liliana back something. Well, actually, if he sacks now, he flips the Liliana without using the first Liliana, so he might want to wait.
Yeah.
Because then getting back, because you could just get back Colostria Healer first and then sack later, but I guess you're just, Lee's just going to go for it now.
And then looks like one of the downsides.
Oh, he sacks the token. Yeah, of course, that makes sense. Because
oh, absolutely.
So sacking the token, you don't draw off hero specs, but that's fine. Then next, now you get to go like Liliana back, Colostria Healer, drain you for one. Sack Sidisi's Faithful, draw two, and
get the new Liliana flipped.
And then get back Sidisi's Faithful to bounce the other 3/4 flyer.
Barring any thunderstorm shenanigans and Lee timing out, I think. I think Dave's time with us is limited.
It is. I mean, Lee could miss here, but the problem is Lee's missing ends up with him with like 10 cards in his hand and Dave with like some 2/2, 1/1s and a 2/2 in play. It's not like Lee loses the game if he misses.
Mm-hmm.
Lee has like Jace that can flash back collected company next turn as well.
This is quite gross.
Oh, yeah. Anyway. So now Lee's in a spot where I don't think he has to just, like, go too deep here. There's no reason to, like, maybe you sack Colostria Healer because that one's kind of free, but you can't win this turn. I don't think you have enough gas to win this turn. So you might as well set it up so that you just can't lose.
Oh, and don't forget, not only do they have all these abilities, they can attack.
So now the World of, or the, not World of the Rogue, Den Protector is an O2 based on Jace plus one-ing. So at best, Dave can double block one of the Grim Horror Spexes and has to block Husk. Husk is just lethal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and even with his sideboard options, I don't see a way for Dave to really come back from this one.
No, he'd have to, like, I'm trying to think, like, maybe like a quarantine field, but I don't see that doing. Like, you can exile Jace and Husk, maybe?
But then they just get sacrificed in response and, you know, one of them can come back.
Yeah. Doesn't seem like it'll do it here.
How many corners do you think Li Shitian has successfully passed or turned this game?
Oh, he's turned all of them. He's in the home ballpark now.
And Dave's probably just doing the calculations, looking through his deck list, what he can draw here. He obviously has to block the Husk, but...
So Dave deciding his best plan is just to chump the Husk, take 6, go to 4. I mean, even like a Planar Outburst or whatever is not really going to do it.
All creatures are dying, are going to put all those Hierospex triggers on the stack. With 2 active planeswalkers on the battlefield. Yowza, yowza, yowza.
When the rally deck plays well, it plays really well. I mean, you're playing a lot of cards that don't look particularly constructed playable on their face, but add them all together and you have a pretty, you know, disgusting engine that just combines, in this case, to draw a bunch of cards, bounce a bunch of creatures, and just put a bunch of creatures on the board.
How are you liking the Jace splash in the rally decks? I see both you and Li Shitian are running the full 4.
Oh, I think it's incredible. Jace is perfect because he's a thing to do on turn 2. He can dig you to anything you're looking for just by looting. A looter would be good in this deck. And can flashback company if you already use company, or flashback rally if it gets discarded or countered. I think Jace really goes a long way to making this deck better, and I can't really imagine playing the deck without blue. I think Jace is really, really good in this.
And the Sidisi's Faithful has been doing a ton of work for Li Shitian this entire
match. We were really happy with Sidisi's Faithful in our list as well. It's just an efficient card that does a bunch of things you want. It can also bounce Anafenza, which may be relevant for me today. We'll see. After all these worrying about Anafenza's, Gerard's just going to crush me. It's just not going to matter.
What is Gerard playing, by the way? I forgot to...
He is playing Esper Dragons.
Okay. A good tried and true method. Don't forget, folks, this is only round 3 of 6. We have 3 more matches to go after this. I know it's getting late, but stay tuned. Watch all of the exciting matches. You thought you would just watch a bunch of Abzan and Dark Jeskai? Well, you're only sort of correct. Look at this sweet 4-color rally and the Bant Tokens matchup. All right, Dave gets a turn here, draws a Silk Wrap. And... I got nothing. I'm sorry, Dave.
Yeah, I think that's a wrap. There's just not a whole lot Dave can do here.
All right. I see what you did there.
Look, I'm not going to say it was silky smooth, but it wasn't that bad.
You know, unlike Dave's hands, these puns, they just don't rock.
Yeah. And at this point, the game's just over, so we're pretty much just winging it. I don't know what else we could be doing.
I mean, Lee's, you know, collecting his things up right now and putting his cards back in the deck box.
He's about to be doing that since, I guess Steve is looking at the fact that Lee has 4 minutes and 50 seconds left. I don't think it's going to come to that, though. Dave just deep in the tank, seeing what gives him his best outs. I mean, I don't know if Silkwrap does it. It's flipping then protector to get back, secure the wastes.
That means he's not going to die from an attack. So I guess that's good.
And then protector is still too small to attack the planeswalkers.
All right, Lee's untapped.
Looks like Lee has a... Is he a rally in hand, or is that a rally literally split card? Because that'd be a powerful card. All right, there we have it.
All right, so maybe games 1 and 3 weren't as exciting. Lee Shitan taking the match there 2-1 over Dave. But Dave got to do what he wanted to do in game 2.
Yeah, that was... that was about how I expect the match to go. The match where Lee's deck misfired, he didn't win. The matches where his deck did its thing, he did win, because Dave couldn't really interact with any of those things. So hopefully we see a similar performance out of Rally next round, since I'm facing off against Gerard Fabiano momentarily. We're going to have some commercial breaks here, and we'll be back in a few minutes.